Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Just an Average Sim Racer. We're back at the ILMS at Spa for the 60-minute race this evening. And we've got a couple of new gadgets to play around with this evening as well. Also, one new gadget anyway, which is the dashboard on top of the monitor. I've got rid of the... Oh, hello. It's already fallen off. Always bodes well when it falls off in the first few seconds. It's a little 5-inch LCD touchscreen that I've purchased from Amazon and built myself the last couple of days, just to have a play basically and see how it works out. So it's basically a dash that appears on the car in live, so I don't have to keep looking at the screen as much as concentrate on the road in front of me. It's a gadget, I don't need it, but it looks nice. I'll try and show you that on a video a bit later on. You can just about see it there. So yeah, we've got the multiple camera, we've got the overhead one, we've got the new one in front of me. So yeah, multi-angle streams, always a nice thing to have. Hopefully my streamline software will work tonight, because it didn't work last night, which really frustrated me. But that's the way it goes sometimes. I couldn't see anything on Twitch. If anything did happen on Twitch, I don't know. Actually, nothing did happen on Twitch, because Twitch is very, very new to the stream. But we are streaming live on Facebook and Twitch at the same time, which is a novelty for myself. So I recommend I should get onto Twitch, have a bit of presence on there. So that's what I'm trying not to do, and failing miserably, which is things. But last night we had I did do the ILMS, did it in a Ford GTE, which was beautiful in the corners at Spa. I had no top end on the setup I had, so I've gone into the BMW for this race, and I hope that the setup I've got is going to be better. My fastest stop was a 2.19.7, which is pretty slow in comparison to what people should be doing on this track. But I'm hoping in practice I'll get some good laps in, turn some good numbers, and we'll see how we go from there, basically. So, let's get out on track and see what we can do. The key of tonight is to concentrate. Stay concentrated. The more concentrate, the better the race will be. Said no one ever, basically. Who knows? But let's get out there. Let's make sure the dash works. Rev to work. Look at that. Nice and live, that one.
Pit lane speed limit is 60 kilometers per hour.
Thank you, Jim Bob. So, crew chief is always running in the background. Race lab apps is the overlays with a sim hub race lap map in the middle.
Traffic approaching, watch your mirrors.
And of course I've got iFlag running on the screen, which you can see flashing away at me. And of course, my headphones are far too... Oh, it's already fallen off. I'm going to pull off. Well, the screen worked for about 5 seconds. Bear me 1 second, chaps, while I fix that. You see, it wasn't what I intended it to do, so I need to take my gloves off now. Technology, when you try and do something novelty, it just fails. Oof. Right, 1 second. Velcro is one of those wonderful things.
When it works, but it doesn't.
It shafts you. We've got a viewer on Twitch. Hello, Mr. Twitch person. Nice to have you on board. Share the word. Give us a follow. Etc, etc. I like follow. That sounds a bit creepy, but hello there. I don't realize how much heat this little monitor pulls out of on the screen. Quite a bit of heat.
Alright, let's get back on. It's getting warm in here already. Let's get the fan on.
Right, there we go.
Yeah.
Basically, bringing out the summer fan. Got warm in here last night when I was racing. Probably not a bad idea to get a fan on for tonight. Actually, got a cushion as well because I've got a numb bum racing. And nobody likes a numb bum rider racing, because that's not fun for anybody. Certainly not me. Right then. Let's take two. It's only practice. I'd say race starts at 10 o'clock. So we'll see what the Beamer can do. I had a good run out last start, so I know the track layout. It's not like I'm learning the track. Just learning the car, basically, on this track.
There's traffic behind.
Looser in the back end. The BMW. Not really, Jack. One of the guys I worked, hang on. So I have to mute it. Take a quick phone call, chaps. 1 second. And I'm back. Sorry about that, chaps. One of the colleagues at work decided to give me a call, ask me a question. Guys I work with, they work until 11 o'clock on a Sunday night. And there's always a question that they need to ask me, so... You never know. Oh, I can't see the screen. Down there. I like to see my overlays off to the top of the right hand side. I like in this new Sim Hub's dash, it's beautifully clear. Beautifully clear. Right then. Some precky out there. Gotta learn. Learn this car. Know what I can and can't do with it on this track. It's always important. Test the limits out.
Okay, Kev, there's a faster car approaching.
Too bad about the fuel because the crew chief takes care of that. Big lift through erosion radio and just get still got time temperature in the tyres yet.
There's a faster class car approaching.
Right side. Clear right. On your right. Clear right.
I mean, did contemplate going for like a LMP1 or LMP2 variant for this series racing. But I do like GTE cars. Ooh. Pima feels nice. It's just now the faster corners. Bigger lift there or... Better braking there. Car feels lovely and stable. I'll definitely give it out.
B27.
This is on a full fuel load as well, so...
Thank you.
a bit of a bottom out understeer through there. Not too bad. Revs are still high. Sorry, man. It bounced off the curb.
Don't worry, don't worry.
Yeah, it's why we practice, isn't it? Make your mistakes now and get it right in the race.
Yeah, don't worry, it's fine, fine.
Bum 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 bum. Not sure if I got to. Really?
There's traffic behind, take care. Disengage limiter.
Clear left.
Off we go. Oh, that's better. More rotation on either's car under braking. One thing I found about the 4GT, I like the 4GT. A little bit more understeery. I think I prefer oversteery. That sounds a setup as well. Okay. Pushing my luck there, but it's only practice still. Treat that as one long bin corner.
Right,
on your right, clear right. A bit wobbly there. We lost it through there, didn't he? Through the gears as many as woo.
There's a faster car approaching.
Audi coming up rocket ship fast, bro.
31.
Car right. Clear right.
Heading by. I'm not in a rush. Practicing. Oh, no, it's all right. A bit of a lock up there.
Pass the car behind.
Left side. Clear left.
taking this car over to Ford GT on this track. It was a lot smoother. I say smooth is not the right word, actually. Ooh, slide it, Kev. Slide it round her. Blanche him on. That's how you do it. Formula One race this afternoon. Boy, how a good race that was. How have we missed that kind of racing in Formula One? So many unknowns. How often do we have to see it where you think the team that's going to win it are just behind and battling for reliability and things like that? Mercedes are not bulletproof. That they're not. Credit to Charles Leclerc for driving the wheels off his Ferrari, which he absolutely did, to get it into second place. But a big result, and I don't see many people covering this, was Lando Norris. An exceptional drive to stay third. He was consistent as well, and then nailed the final lap for the fastest lap. Can't really fault that, can you? I see you, Mr. LMP.
On your left, clear left.
Still his draft. Oh, bugger off. Bottled it. If you were sensible. Nice little lock up there. Through the bus stop. Nice.
You're currently 6.1 off the pace.
This car is smooth through there, even in the dirty air. That was nice.
Sorry, then.
Car behind's a faster class.
Racing. The lift there, which wasn't ideal. Where's he going? Oh, he held it together though. Guy behind me. He was sideways through there. Oh yeah, oh yeah. 218s.
Our back was a 218 and 6-2.
I'm liking this now. Definitely the right choice of car. So, we could do a tree conceal, but I ain't got time to worry about that. Up at the moment, I'll give him that. People join the track like absolute monkeys.
How's your head?
Whoever that was who decided to join the track at a right angle to the racing line, 10 out of 10, guys. That's a good time to get out of the lobby and change over to the race lobby. Because that was a bit of a crash, wasn't it? Right, 1 second. Just jumped on watching the stream apparently. It says bring them on camera. It's on Facebook anyway. I have no idea what it does. Good news is it's still actually using the Twitch stream. Which is fine. There we go. Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps register. BMW M8 GTE. He belched down the microphone. Signature that is belching down the microphone. Whew, it's getting warm in here. And my iPad is covering over. Yeah. My fan. Much air. A bit of a circuit guide about Spa, Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps. It's a cracking track though. You can't fault the layout of it. But that proper old world kind of vibe to it. Yeah, I like this little screen that I put together. Need to find a suitable mount for it because I discovered the mount I had was probably not quite suitable, but I've got a workaround at the moment, which I'm playing around with, so sussed that one out properly. I think we're good. Doesn't look too bad as well. Doesn't look too bad. But let's go. So we've got 15 minutes, 10 minutes, 10 minutes till the race starts. Jesus. Display capture. Make sure game capture's on. Game capture. Give me a precious few extra frame rates, I'd say. Precious few frame rates. It's tilting every time, I guess. When technology fails you, I'm trying to put it all back together again.
The track temperature's decreasing. It's now 33 Celsius.
Proper janky way doing it. We like janky. Stay. Running. Race time. Pretty. Not comfortable. Ever. Lower fuel in the car. Practice. Because that always helps do some practice qualifying, I find.
Pit lane speed limit is 60 kilometers per hour. Your exit is clear. Watch the white line.
It's an easy track to make a mistake on as well. Lose your concentration as I did a couple of times last night. Nice and smooth, nice and smooth. No, it's actually got a fuel gauge on this screen as well, so it doesn't actually matter. series get greedy on that corner. Like that. Another off track, so you've got to be quite careful. Make sure you get your apex early. Nice. Barely lifted through there. Feeling a lot more positive about this race coming up than where I was last night in this car, so definitely a right choice to switch cars over.
Sector 2 is 0.42 off the pace. Sector 3 is 0.7 off the pace. That lap was a 2:18.36. Very little fuel left. Coming to the pits at the end of this lap. Box this lap.
I was on a limit through there, that was. Right on the limit. I do love this track when you're in full flow.
Sector 1 is 0.36 off the base.
That jobby coming up here, Tums.
Sector 2 is 0.5 off the pace.
We'll be right back.
time is just done at 2:21.15.
I'll take a 2:17.
This session, you're a second off the pace in sector 1. Sector 2 is 1.2 off the pace. Sector 3 is 0.16 off the pace. You've just done a 2:18.00.
Get down. Being close to it. Alright, let's get into the race. Cue the fancy graphics. I'll see you guys on the other side if you're watching. Good evening and welcome to Just an Average Sim Racer. We're here in the ILMS race, the 60-minute races at Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps. It's a 20-turn theatre of speed and legendary racing, and we're here in an attempt to tackle it in a 1.1k strength of field race in the BMW M8 GTE. And you can see there with a new fancy overlay making the stream look ever so slightly more shitter. Yeah, it kind of works. Makes it look smart anyway. But thanks for joining. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Kev. This is Just an Average Sim Racer. We've got a lot going on in this race. We've got qualifying going straight away, because that's always a key thing to get going with. I think I'm fueling. Lower down. Yep, done. Let's get out there and get qualifying. So I had a good practice session. Felt pretty confident about that. About where that practice session went.
Your lane speed limit is 60 kilometers per hour. Your exit's clear. Don't cross the white line. Okay, Kev, we've got 2 laps. Let's get this done.
Time is sort of quite critical in this car, in this track qualifying. It would just be GTEs. Imagine. Next week it's Suzuka, I think. Don't hit the wall. First time I've done that. There's another cars on track. driving. I mean, just brake far too late for a corner. That was. hoping tonight's race is going to be of significantly better than yesterday's race. It actually didn't start off too bad. I was actually doing all right, but... in the Ford GTE yesterday. It was good in the corners, but just didn't have any top end, which is important on Spa, I think. Just having that top end speed. Don't wreck the car, you don't need to go too fast into the chicane. Good exit, that's a good start. Let's get going. Way too deep into the source. Bad corner. Maintain good speed through Eau Rouge and Radium. Smooth. Liking this, Sinbad. That's someone did a 2:15. Really deep there. Here was bang, 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 bang. Nice and smooth.
fastest lap for Nagi, 217.34.
Down a couple of places, sixth place. Slower. So much time to made up a little sauce there. Eighth place. I'll take that. I'll take eighth place on the grid.
That's the end of the session.
Compared to where I was yesterday. 3 seconds a lap quicker.
Practice.
Practice does make perfect, they say. Oh, drop frame rates. 11% over 2 minutes ago. That's all right. So where's my drink gone? That's the last drink I want to be getting. Right, let's grid up. Get the tyres sorted. Tyres seem to last quite well. I think in the last race. Not too concerned. Oh, no. I forgot to do my fuel like an absolute empty. I'll just subscribe to which is. Oh, cheap. Ah, that's right. I'm at 18.2.
Screen.
Yeah, I'm not fueled up for the start of this race. Fuck! Oh, dear me. Do I start from the pit lane? Can I go a full race?
P8.
I'm going to manage it, am I?
22 Celsius. The track temp is 32 Celsius.
Oh, rookie error, Kev. Rookie error. Didn't change my fuel for the race.
We need to follow car number
4 12. 4 litres.
Okay, Kev, are you ready? Watch for the lights.
Get a few laps out there quickly.
No.
Clear
right.
On your right.
Clear
left. Clear left. Left side. Still there. Clear left.
contact. Deep.
Thank you.
Okay, that was not a bad start to the race. Made up a few positions.
This hard road to good use, V7. You
should get it from the stupid one. Take it easy, Ferrer. Sensible, isn't it, Ferrer Rouge? Cars are still not quite... Well, they're pretty warm.
Sector 1 is 0.8 off the pace. The leader has just done 216.66.
I'm keeping pace with a very low fuel load. Apologies for the Spanish language. I can't act in until just having a chat amongst themselves here. I think it's Spanish.
Perfect.
Could be Portuguese.
That's half fuel. You've used half your fuel. Okay, Caps, just cut the track.
First incident point.
tarmac 6. We're running on fumes, mate. In this lap, box this lap, please, Kev.
Make it round and up after this one.
Herrera is reading you in. The gap's now 3.7. It's faster than you in 2 plus horse.
It's faster than me in a 30 mile an hour corner.
Sector 1 is 0.8 off the pace.
So I've got a pit now, end of this lap. I made a rookie error at the beginning of the race by not changing my fuel load.
Watch your speed. Mid lane speed limit is 60 kilometers per hour.
Clear left.
Box in. 10.
There's a lot of cars in the pit lane. A lot of cars in the pit lane.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
Okay, here we go. Question is, will I get to the end of the race? That is the question. I don't think I will. So that's the thing, this is touch and go for a splash and dash at the end of the race, I reckon. Because I screwed up. It's about 22 laps for a fuel tank, I reckon. And 19. Bollocks.
There's traffic behind. Keep your wits about you. Limiter's still on. Disengage it.
I was actually thinking, should I put the tyres on there maybe? Not worth it. go and get some places back. Unscathed. Oh, come on. You make one mistake, you make another one straight after. B30. Come on, then. Car feels fine. Into the routine, pay attention to the track, Kev. Way too deep in that corner. Oh my god, Kev, what are you doing? Sort it out. Sort it out. Oh, well, there's two in a row. Still feels relatively fun. I'm making a mess of this, aren't I? Already. Come on. Now I avoided more serious damage there, to be honest, but I did.
stay on your line, man.
Eres un subnormal, cabrón.
You fucking cabrón.
Es un intento. You're an stupid
go inside and look for speed, idiot.
But that's the real motor, you are very idiot. Right, idiot. Cállate, alcohólico.
Shut up, you ass.
Saturra, campora. Lloran, Saturra, campora.
Incident in La Source. We think it might be Vera.
On your left, clear left.
I think I might have some aero damage a little bit from that. Raise of the wall.
Verán, te voy a reportar. Sí, lo hago, lo voy a recortar, porque acabo de ver la repetición y me ha salido por mí cuatro veces. Lo voy a recortar. Cerdo.
Left side. Clear left.
And smooth. Yeah, they've got some aero damage I'm not keeping. Nailed it through erosion radion again. Nailed it. Thank you. Oh, excuse me. I'm in full concentration mode, that's why I can't really do commentary and talk at the same time, yeah? I'm going slow up ahead again.
There's an incident in the chicane. It looks like Gutierrez.
I'm back in the pits again by the look of it. Another pit stop.
It's behind his pitting.
Short of fuel, and I can't fuel save that much. I think again, anyway.
There's an incident in La Source. We think it might be Gutierrez.
Again?
Incident in Roxelles. Fuel window will open after 38 minutes, closes after 44 minutes.
Which corner Stablo is, I can never remember which one that one.
The track temp's increasing, it's now 34 Celsius. A little bit more than I wanted to do. Incident in the chicane.
Oops. A bit curb hoppy, but that's all right.
B26.
Five minutes still to go of the race. Averaging speed nicely through there.
There's an incident in Lake Hoop. Looks like it's Paris.
Just joining on the stream, we're in the ILMS 60 minute race here at Spa. Made a return to the BMW M8 GTE for this race, and it's certainly been a better car than the Ford GTE I did racing last night. Fortunately, I made a very rookie mistake and forgot to change my fuel load at the very beginning of the race from a quali load, which means I will be having just to stop this race. Complete rookie error. I started 8th in quali as well, so I actually had an amazing quali race for me. But just didn't sit up properly in for the actual race. Wasn't paying attention. How are you, Chris? Yeah, that old chestnut completely dawned on me just as the race was just about to get in the way. I was like, oh no. Complete rookie mistake as well. I've had good pace in this race as well. I've been pretty good. Much better race than last night, I'll tell you that much. About an average of 3 seconds lap quicker, it feels like. Been in the Ford. Really wait for that corner. I mean, it's the first time I've ever done it as well. Normally I'm pretty sensible and just completely forgot. Couple of spins, some at Blanche at this corner here. Actually, we're just clipping the curb on the way in. Certainly a lot smoother tonight.
That
was 220.47. Oh, a lot quicker than a 220, that is. Fuel load. I mean, before I pitted, I was as high as, I think, sixth place, I think.
Distance.
So I had the pace to be up there, but just...
It's fuel remaining.
Bad prep. Bad prep. Stable than yesterday. Different, I say. The car is a star. Right, but the setup's much more stable. We've got a better top end speed, and the car is faster as well. So, yeah, we're looking a treat tonight. But I can actually attack it as well. Lift there just to get around it. Sure, why my blue light was flashing at me. One day, mate. Go. One day.
1.9 seconds.
Never ruling it out. Never ruling it out. Hey, make a donation to the stream if you want, Chris. We can put it towards a VR fund. Shrill!
Nice and tidy.
That guy behind me, that's had to take easy. Only do you only got a 1080 Ti. Do you know what? 1080 Ti is more than capable. More than capable for any racing game at the moment, still. Even for ACC. To be honest, I wouldn't even recommend getting a 2080 Ti until there's more widespread ray tracing on games.
There's an incident in. Looks out.
Turn 13, this one.
Incident in campus.
Yep.
The gap behind has now decreased to 1.5. Smooth. Slower. It's possibly tyres though. Quite as much grip. Ooh. Mr. Nagy. Okay, Kev. The next car is Nagy.
Careful, Evan. Comes to the back of this guy.
Incident in
A little bit deep there.
The gap to nudge from the head is now 0.9.
Cheers, dude. Thanks for joining in again, mate. I'll probably be back on Wednesday night next round I catch him. Take it easy. Look after yourself, pal.
There's an incident in La Source.
Smoothie does it.
Time was 2:20.38. The lead car's pitting. Okay, Kev, that's good consistency. Keep it up.
Yeah, I'm doing solid laps, but nothing spectacular. Lift out of that one a little bit.
incident in the chicane. Looks like it's Ellis.
Manhart's in the pits.
P17, that was a 220.47. The leader's pitting now.
Five laps of fuel left. 10 minutes, ain't gonna happen, is it? Gonna have to be a splash and dash right near the end, unfortunately. Today's lesson is racing is to make sure you fuel your car up with fuel before the race starts. Don't do what I did and run start in qualifying fuel load. I realised, oh no, we're going to get so far until your race becomes a two-stop race.
Alright Kev, 15 minutes left, that's 15 minutes. An incident in campus. You think it might be Ellis?
Really deep there, Kev.
Gap to Ellis.
Excuse me.
0.6. B15.
Bien.
Right side. Clear right.
No, Kev. Come on, mate. Defend your position.
What if he didn't drive like a tit? Somehow. How you dodge it? Okay, is it going again? Reset. Getting numb again.
There's incident in the chicane. We think it might be Ellis.
That's good for me. This is pit, and Beckett is 20 seconds behind on road. Let's see what I can stretch in these next few laps. The tyres feel really good actually. Which is important, I think, on a trick like this. Maintain your grip. I'm not at the pace I was at, because the tyres will go off. Actually, they feel. Nope. It's the first time I've done that there. Fuck me. Get off the racing line, Kev. Park it.
Okay, Kev, 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left.
Just getting a little bit. You need to keep attacking the car. If you let yourself go conservative, it doesn't do what you want it to do when you make a silly mistake like that. Yeah, which is surprising, so I'll take that. Take that very nicely indeed.
Sector 1 is 1.2 seconds off the pace.
Such a numb bum. We'll be right back.
on fumes, mate. In this lap, box this lap. That's good consistency. Keep it up.
You taking a piss, Jim? Is on fumes.
Put your head back together. Look out for the pit speed limit. Watch your speed. Okay, we'll fill you to the end. Box in 1,010 feet.
Numbum, numbum.
Just a slow pit lane.
Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
Oh my god, optional pairs, I ain't doing that. Go, 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 go. No. Fucking hell, Kev. You absolute prick. Oh, my God. Well, that's a way to ruin your race, wasn't it?
Take care, there's a car approaching. Disengage limiter.
A moron.
On your left. Clear left.
Well, still 17th place, which is still positive for me. Still positive I rating, I'll take that.
Left. Clear left.
That was rubbish.
2 minutes left. 2 minutes.
Oh, I believe I was split in the pit lane. Pit exit. How embarrassing. idea. Probably be white flag lap next time round. Big lift up there.
Green flag.
Annoying thing is, if I just had kept rid of the guys at the front, I probably would have filled up properly, I would have had a decent race. Nowhere near me, mate. I'll see you, mate, but I'm out of here.
Okay, Kev, we estimate you've got 5 minutes of fuel remaining.
Go on, guys, go, 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 go. These two guys are battling, so I don't want to get in the way of these guys. I'll take that. Oh, my legs have gone numb now. Proper numb. That actually wasn't a bad race in the end, actually. I quite enjoyed that. If I hadn't have screwed up my stupidity of fueling at the beginning, I probably would have been top 10, I reckon. I actually think I would have been top 10. Fear not, I still had a positive I rating. I think my safety rating will take a good increase as well, which is also important for these races. I mean, from 30 odd cars in the race. Got one there. What was it, 40 cars that raced in this one. So I'm pretty happy with where I came out, actually. Top half of the field. Always in for the top half. So pretty happy with that. Some good racing out there tonight, boys. Enjoyed that one. Somewhere, whatever. I think it's a lap down. Yesterday, I think it's two laps down in the end yesterday, so I had a much better pace. Much, much better pace. Good quality lap, what I managed to put in. And, yeah, good fast lap as well, 2:18.504, which is only a second off the top guys. Lap, so I'm happy with that. I'm happy. That's a positive race. Right, let's have a look at the results on the main screen once I sort out that one. Sort out my replay file. Sunday. Save. Next week's, I think, Suzuka, if I remember rightly. Yo. Where's it gone? Where's it gone? This is on my reason. Obviously, I use the Streamlabs app for controlling my stream. And sometimes it just gets rid of half the buttons. Like, well, where's that gone? So, 1 second, I'll just find the right display button manually. Display capture. Hello, display. We got results already. Let's see what the damage was. Good safety rating gain, 17, and then an iRacing gain of 15, back to 11.92. So I'm happy with that. That was a solid race. This ILMS race. That's what I needed, a bit of a confidence boost. I had a couple of spins, which was purely my fault. I didn't have any contact with anyone. My own mistakes. I can live with that. I can absolutely live with that. I look at Donington Park. There's a race tonight at Donington Park. Do I want to get involved? No, it's too late. I work tomorrow and it's Sunday. I don't want to do another race. So that's it for me. Been a pleasure. Thank you for joining. A lot of people seem to have come and gone during the stream on Facebook. Twitch. Don't really know how accurate Streamlabs app is for conveying the strip side of things. The stream assigned things on the app. So thank you guys for joining in. It's been a lovely Sunday night here at the rig side. And I'll see you guys another night. Next scheduled stream will be on Wednesday night. Could be Tuesday night, depending on what happens to takeaway in this house, because one of those nights is typically takeaway night. Whatever night that falls on, means it gets pushed around. So either Tuesday night or Wednesday night. I'll be the next live stream. That will be the BMW M4 GT4s and 12.0 Championship, which next week takes in Detroit Grand Prix at Belle Isle. I don't mind that actually, but it's just. next week's ILMS races come to you from Suzuka. Look at the all time classic track. So Suzuka is where we're at next week in the ILMS. Not a bad track for me typically in GTE cars. So if I can get the right setup and get loose on there. That's it for me, guys, though. Thank you for joining in. It's been my absolute pleasure. I hope you enjoyed the stream and give us a like, give us a follow. If you want to catch up, watch over on YouTube as well. I'll see you guys very soon. Good night.